Today at lunch, when you look down at that beautiful meal in front of you, you may have experienced the strange fluid taking over your mouth. Well, don't worry, you probably have felt this before, so it's all normal. That fluid is called saliva, and it comes from structures called salivary glands. You might be asking now, what are salivary glands? Well, that's a mystery no man has ever been able to answer. No, I'm just kidding. We actually know a few things about the salivary glands, that's why on this video we'll be taking you through a short overview of the main salivary glands, their functions, and the location, and because we love anatomy so much, we're going to go into arterial blood supply and venous drainage for each. We're of course going to begin with this image of the right lateral view of the head with the skin cut away. If you're like me, the next time you see someone singing, you might think of this image. You're welcome. There are lots of things happening here, lots of structures, but just as a reference point, here we can see the tongue highlighted in blue. Before I tell you what are the major salivary glands, we need to answer that previous question. What is a salivary gland? Let me give you here the definition, and a salivary gland is a secretory gland that, well, secretes tasteless and clears saliva, which has many important functions in your body, such as keeping the mucous membrane of the mouth moist. Yes, that's exactly what you felt at the beginning of this tutorial. Salivary glands help us lubricate food. They also prevent tooth decay and are involved in the initial steps of digestion. The salivary glands in our body can be divided into major and minor salivary glands. But in this video, we will be giving you a quick overview of the anatomy of the major salivary glands. And they are the sublingual, the submandibular, and the parotid glands. Now, we're just going to briefly cover these glands here in this tutorial, but if you want a little bit more in-depth discussion on the major salivary glands, you can head to the main Kenhub website. So first up in our list, we have this one here, which is the sublingual gland. The sublingual gland is an almond-shaped gland, which is also the smallest gland out of the major salivary glands. It also secretes the smallest amount of saliva per day. The sublingual glands lie bilaterally on the floor of your mouth, so you have one on each side. And these glands have several ductal openings that run along the margin of the sublingual folds, just around here. As for the arterial blood supply of the sublingual gland, there are two separate arteries supplying it. These are the sublingual artery, which you see here, and is a branch of the lingual artery. The other artery supplying the sublingual gland is the submental artery, a branch of the facial artery, which has been cut out of this image, but looks something like this. Now we're going to be talking about the veins, and remember that the veins responsible for draining the sublingual gland are the veins that have corresponding names to those of the arteries. For that reason, if you remember well the arteries that I just mentioned before, you're going to have then a sublingual vein, which you see here right next to the sublingual artery. And the second vein is then the submental vein, following a similar path as the submental artery. Let's move on to the next major salivary gland, which is the submandibular gland. This one is situated close to the sublingual gland. The submandibular glands are located both superiorly and inferiorly to the inner aspect of the mandible in the submandibular triangle of the neck, seen now highlighted in green, which happens to also be known as the digastric triangle. You can see here the mandible cut and its relation to the submandibular gland. The submandibular gland shares the same arterial blood supply as the sublingual gland. It is supplied by the submental artery, a branch of the facial artery, and the sublingual artery, which is then a branch of the lingual artery. In terms of venous drainage, the submandibular gland is mainly drained by the submental vein, which anastomosis, in other words, connects with then the sublingual vein. Now on to the final major salivary gland, and may I say one of the most popular, the parotid gland. You can see this structure highlighted here on the picture. The parotid gland is the largest of the major salivary glands, maybe that is why people love it so much. It is located in front of your ear, in a place known as the preauricular region. The parotid gland has a rich blood supply due to its constant saliva production, especially during meal times. I'd like to also mention that the parotid gland has an irregular-shaped parotid bed, or nest, which can otherwise be described as the structure surrounding and touching the parotid gland. And you see the parotid bed now highlighted in green. Now let's talk about the arterial supply of the parotid gland. The blood supply to the parotid gland comes from three of the branches of the external carotid artery, which are the superficial temporal artery, which you see a bit here on the image, the maxillary artery, which would be around here, and the transverse facial artery. In terms of venous drainage, the parotid gland is drained mainly by the retromandibular vein. And so that's it. A sweet, short, and snappy overview of the main salivary glands. What more could you possibly ask for? Well, perhaps you're actually looking for a more detailed review of the salivary glands. Although we poured our blood, sweat, and tears into this video, we wouldn't hold it against you. Sometimes your studies require you to learn a lot of detailed and boring information, and there is nothing to be done but to just get on with it. If that sounds like you, then don't despair, really. Over on our main website, you can find the full video on the main salivary glands with clinical notes, which might be useful to you. It's actually super fun, and you won't even fall asleep watching it. Unless you're really, really sleepy, then I can't do much about it. Then head over to kenhub.com to try it for yourself. We'll meet you there. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Until next time, guys, thanks for watching.